Karl Anthony Towns. 10 points, 4 boards, 2 of 7 from the field, 1 of 5 from downtown in his Knicks debut. What'd you like about Cat tonight, man? Talk to me about Cat, man.
So, what I like is that you can see the spacing with this team, right? I'm looking forward to seeing what everything looks like when this team is in rhythm. You see that it's just everyone just has to get in a groove, right? It's a little shaky. Not everyone was on their A game tonight, but you see what this team is trying to do from an offensive standpoint. You like that Karl Anthony Towns can space the four. I mean, how about that deep three that he took today, you know? But, man, I just want to see this team rolling, man, because we didn't really get to see much of that. Brunson misses some shots here and there. He had some nice, you know, cuts from OG and so forth. But from Cat, man, I just want to see him being able to space the floor. It's nice that he could take it off the dribble and attack the rim. He's going to be just spacing the floor for the entire team. That's all I can really say from the get-go. It's nice that he could put the floor on the deck, the ball on the deck.
Yeah.
You know, pause. But hey.
Yeah.
Good stuff so far from Cat. What do you like?
Yeah, good stuff. I mean, you know, he played as I expected him to. First shot of the game, comes in and knocks down a three. Let me just reset that there. Comes in and knocks down a three, first shot of the game. You know, they were running some plays for him out of the post, out of the low post. So I like what I saw from Towns, man. I thought he was active out there. I'm trying to get the Towns highlights up. I had the highlights there, but it didn't come across. But, you know, similar to how they would run offense through Hartenstein, you're going to see the same with Towns, but more efficient, more effective, and he's going to be able to use his size. Jalen can play off of him. You saw some nice cuts off of those Towns low post entry passes. Making some plays at the top of the key. Defensively, I thought he was strong. I thought he was solid defensively in protecting the rim. I thought he did a good job overall, man.
For sure. Defensively is where I was actually really impressed, because when he was out in Minnesota, right, he always played at the level when it came to like opposing teams sitting at screen, right? And, of course, you have Rudy Gobert back there, so out in Minnesota, so they were able to do stuff like that, and also to shade Towns' weakness in working in drop coverage, because he doesn't have the quickness, the lateral quickness and the recovery speed, or even that ability to leap like Mitchell Robinson. Yeah. But what I did like from the defensive end from Cat is that you saw that there was still some rim protection. He's not a high flyer as we get out of Mitch, but still you saw he was able to get some blocks, protect the paint at a decent level. I mean, he is going against Nick Richards. So
yeah,
it's nothing too crazy. You know, I want to see what it looks like against better big, someone like Kristaps Porzingis, Joel Embiid. You want to talk about Nikola Jokic. I want to see what it looks like when Cat has to go against other elite centers or top centers in the league, because that's really going to be a testament to how this defense able to maneuver, right? So I'm looking to see how Tibbs is going to adapt when we play better teams moving forward. But for tonight, man, Tibbs went back to his tried and true drop coverage, and Karl Anthony Towns was able to do the damn thing tonight. So defensively, wasn't too bad. But look, man, it's the Charlotte Hornets. I don't want to overreact too much, man.
Yeah,
I don't want to overreact
but
too much.
But this is what we do, man. Go ahead, man. Don't be ashamed, man.
I'm trying to temper expectations, man. I'm trying to temper expectations.
Go ahead and jump, man.
I still need to see stuff, man. I still need to see things play out during the regular season. Like I said, let's see him play against the top centers in the NBA. But for tonight, man, if you're a Knicks fan, you got to be pretty optimistic, because if Tibbs is still able to play drop coverage with Karl Anthony Towns, then defense may not take a big slip, especially as I was looking for this team on the onset.
To the bench, another storyline, very important. Knicks bench last year, one of the worst scoring-wise in the NBA. But our guy picked up right where he left off, man, and that is Deuce McBride. The Dukes was loose today. Got into his bag, 8 of 18 from the field, 4-9 from downtown, 22 points for Deuce. He looked good, man. He looked very good, and he's going to be very important. With Dante gone, Deuce becomes vital to the second unit's success, man.
CP, how about him just like, I don't know about you, but because since I'm not in New York, I couldn't have the, you know, the pleasure of listening to Breen do the broadcast. Yeah. I was listening to the Hornets broadcast, which was pretty entertaining. Okay. They were shocked, as I was, when McBride just pump fake, sidestep, knocked down a three. And I was like, okay, yeah, this is very different. Yeah. This is very different from the Miles McBride that we used to see, man. This was a guy that was timid to shoot, that when he did shoot, it was just like, it was like either going into outer space, it was hitting the back iron, everywhere but the net. And to have that type of confidence, it still looks like he's playing against the Philadelphia 76ers like we saw last season, CP. Yep. So, and he's still picking up 94 feet, too, in preseason. This is totally a Tibbs guy. You know, shout out to Chris Persianen, who, you know, said the Knicks had some sort of interest in Marcus Smart. I don't know why you have that type of interest when you got somebody like Miles McBride on this roster after. And I get it. I get that it's preseason, but still, this guy looks like he is not skipping a beat. He has been putting in that work. And he, look, man, he's the sixth man. First guy coming off the bench, and rightfully so. And you see it. The one thing I want to see more of, though, him attacking the basket. That's the only thing. Because I think everything else is going to be fine. His jump shot's going to be fine. We know defensively he's going to be fine. He's going to be tenacious on that side of the ball, on that side of the court. But I just need to see him just get comfortable driving to the rack and converting at a high rate. Because if he can do that, then we're really talking about him being able to bend the defense.
That would be ideal. But you saw the bench configuration that they had out there. It was Campaign pushing the point and having Deuce play off of him. And I think that's what you're going to see, at least in the onset. We'll get to Kolick in a little bit. But I think you're going to see Campaign as that point guard running off the bench with Deuce playing off of him. But also on the bench, you know, overreaction be damned. I think Landry Shamet made the team tonight.
He did.
16 points, 6 of 11, 4 of 8 from downtown, moving without the ball, moving well. I think Landry Shamet legitimately made the Knicks tonight. Exhibit 9 contract. He needs a spot, man.
When you can shoot, man, you always got a spot in the NBA, especially the way that it's going. Yeah. You know, I know there's been questions about his game in the league for so long, but man, you just see him go 6-0 for 11 from the field, 4-8 from down. That's what you need coming off the bench, man. Yeah. And he's going to be able to space, especially if you want to help McBride be able to get downhill, or even Campaign, or even Tyler Kolick, man. We gotta talk about Kolick for a second. But for guys like that, that's why you have someone like Landry Shamet. And even look, when they brought the starters back in, it was, I think it was Brunson, it was Cat, and they brought Josh Hart back in. They still left Shamet and McBride out there, right? And I'm wondering, like, you don't do it for too long because Shamet doesn't have great defense. Right. But still, if he's on a heater, you can leave him out there, and that's still, you still get space, man. Yeah. You're still going to have space for Brunson to attack, even for Cat. Like, this is just, man. I've never seen this team with so much shooting.
Did a good job. Two steals. Got into the passing lanes. Thought he was active, very active on both ends of the floor. And so, you know, with that last spot between him, TJ Warren, like, I don't see why he can't. With Mook gone, I think that last spot will go to Shamet. You need that shooting off the bench, man. You need some firepower and some more shooting efficiency, especially with Dante gone. Like, it's up to Deuce. Shamet's going to be one of those guys. Campaign, I don't know. I think he'll ultimately shoot his way out of the rotation and you'll get Kolick in there. But, you know, between Deuce and Shamet, that's your firepower off the bench. You're going to need that. Let's talk about Tyler, the creator, man. Let's go.
Because this guy, I'm like, thought
he looked good.
There were rumors where he was going to, you know, have a roster spot or depth chart spot over Campaign. And I was wasn't too shocked, but I was like, man, I like to see Kolick against the second units right now. But then he gets in there, and then you start to see the creation. He doesn't waver under any pressure whatsoever. That is beautiful. The fact I'm watching him do slip screen passes to guys cutting down the middle of the lane. Yep. I'm seeing him knock down threes. It is insane what he is doing as a rookie. I get that it's preseason, but if he's not in the rotation from day one of the regular season, he is going to fight and get a spot higher up on the depth chart than where he is right now. He will not be wearing green or whatever that practice color is for too long, CP. Yeah. He is going to get in over Campaign because the facilitating, the shooting, you need, and you even defensively, you see him getting the block, then knocking down a three. That's what you need from a guy coming off the bench. And I think him next to Deuce, especially if you got Deuce as a shooter and you have someone that is just as calm and patient as Kolek, that's tough, man. That'll be a tough bench.
Yeah, he looked good, man. First bucket, step into a three. You saw a nice little two-man game where he fed Precious for the lay-in off the pick and roll. That was nice. I mean, Kolek picking up right where he left off, man. Doesn't seem like there's a defense out there that is, too much for him to handle at the next level. Defensively is where he's going to get tested. All right, when he got into the game, he gave up a bucket, so he's going to get tested defensively. But offensively, he's ready to roll, and it's only a matter of time before he gets campaign spot. We'll see what Tibbs does. You know how situational he'll be and how he'll grow into his role. But he's going to get that spot sooner than later.